Okay, so the next topic is minors and cofactors. This topic plays a very, very important role in the applications of determinants. So you need to be thorough with the basic concepts so we can apply it in order to find the inverse, in order to solve the system of equation. Everywhere you need this minors and cofactors. And remember, if you are like very clear with minors, only then you can find cofactors. So they are interdependent. So first we'll study about minors. Okay, so minor, as the definition says, first we'll read out the definition. We try to analyze it through an example. Okay, so minor of an element aij. Okay, so we observe here, minor is about element of a determinant. It is not about the entire determinant. Each element has a minor. Okay. So, minor of an element aij, where I represents the row in which A is present and j represents the column in which A is present. Okay, that is the position. I and j are the position in which row, in which column A is present. Okay, of a determinant is the determinant. Again, minor of an element is again a determinant obtained by, okay, how you will get it? You will get it by relating ith row and jth column. So if A is in the first row and third column, okay, if A is situated in first row and third column, so how you will get the minor of A? By deleting first row and third column. Okay, first row and third column in which that particular element lies. Okay, for example, okay, suppose your determinant delta is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, your determinant delta is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, I want to find the minor of 1. Okay, I want to find the minor of 1. Remember, minors will represent, minor of aij they represent it as mij, capital mij. Ij is saying the position where A is situated. So I want to find the, suppose your delta is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and if I ask you to find the minor of 1, okay, I want to find the minor of 1. So minor of 1. So, 1 is in which position? It is in first row and first column. So, yeah, minor of 1 can be represented as M11. It is in first row, first column. So, what it is, according to the definition, you have to delete the row in which it is present and column in which it is present. So, you have to delete the row and column. So, if you delete the first row and first column, what is the element remaining? 4. So, what is the minor of 1? It is 4. Similarly, minor of 3 we will find. Okay, minor of 2. So, minor of 2. 2 is in which position? It is in first row and second column. 2 is situated in first row and second column. So, minor is M12. First row, second column. So, what you have to do in order to find the minor? I have to delete the row and column in which 2 is present. So, 2 is present in first row and second column. So, if you delete first row and second column, what is the element that is remaining? Is 3. Now, again, minor of 3. How to find the minor of 3? 3 is situated in first row column and second row. Second row and first column. 3 is situated in second row and first column. After delete second row and first column, so remaining element is 2. What is minor of? What is the minor of? Minor of 4. It is M22. I have to delete the second row and second column. Answer is 1. Now observe, what are the 4, 3, 2, 1? It is nothing but the determinant, correct? Again, if you find this is nothing but determinant. What is the determinant of a single element? Element itself is 3, to 1. So I hope now you are clear with the definition. Minor of an element Aij, here if you take 1, of a determinant is the determinant, okay, is again the determinant obtained by deleting the ith row, or here it is first row and first column in which the element lies. Okay, this was about 2 cross 2 matrix. We can't find the minor of 1 cross 1 matrix. So the minimum requirement in order to find the minor, the determinant should be of the order 2 cross 2. Okay, suppose you have 3 cross 3 matrix. So delta is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, you can find the minor of each and every element. I show you the minor of 2 or 3 elements, later you can find it out. Suppose I want to find the minor of, I want to find the minor of 6. Okay, I want to find the minor of 6. So 6 is in which position? You can see it is in second row and third column. So second row and third column. Correct? 6 is in second row and third column. What you have to do? You have to delete the second row and third column. If you delete second row and third column, what are the elements remaining? 1, 2, 7, 8. So it is nothing but 1, 2, 7, 8 determinant. How I did here? The same way. Here it was only single element, so it is determinant of row. Here if you delete second row and third column, your determinant is reduced to 2 cross 2 matrix. 2 cross 2, a quarter 2 cross 2, where it is 1, 2, 7, 8. Now you know how to find the determinant of a 2 cross 2 or of order 2. So how to find? Cross multiply. 1 into 8 is 8 minus 7 into 2 is 14. Okay? So it is minus 6. Now if you want to find the minor of 7, suppose you want to find the minor of 7. That is, 7 is in which position? It is in third row and first column. Always remember, first you have to write the row number and then the column. So it is third row and first column. So it is third row, first column. So what you have to do? You have to delete third row and first column. If you delete third row and first column, what are the elements you are what are the elements that is remain? That is 2, 3, 5, 6. Correct? 2, 3, 5, 6. So now it is a 2 cross 2 of determinant of order 2 cross 2. So now if the determinant is 2 into 6 is 12 minus 15 is equal to minus 3. So minor of 7 is minus 3. If in case you have a question where you need to find the minor of this particular determinant, then what you have to do? You have to find the minor of each and every element in the determinant. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. All the elements in the determinant you have to find. So this is about the minor. Now there is a remark. Minor of an element of a determinant of order n. Yes, you can see n should always be greater than or equal to 2. So you can't find the minors of a determinant of order 1. It should be either 2 or greater than 2. Is the determinant of order n minus 1? If my determinant is of order 2, then minor will be of the order 1 less than that, that is 1. If my determinant is of order 3, then my minor will be of the order 2. 3 minus 1 is 2. You can see that. Here the determinant was of the order 2. So minor was the determinant of order 1. Here the determinant is of order 3. So minor is of the order 2. So why we need this minor? In order to find the determinant or to give a mathematical expression to determinant, which we will see in the further class. So, I'll give some of the questions related to minors, so you'll be comfortable in finding the minors, okay, as a homework, so that once you practice, you'll be clear.